obviously insurance is substantial. So insurance could very well be, I don't know, 30, 40% of the value of the car business, frankly. And as we've talked about before, with a much better feedback loop, instead of it being statistical, it can be specific. Now, obviously, somebody does not have to choose our insurance, but I think a lot of people will. It's going to cost less and be better, so why wouldn't you?
Hey, I'm Stephen, and this is Solving the Money Problem. If you're new, welcome. If you're not, welcome back. So on Tesla's Q3 2020 earnings call, Elon Musk had some rather confusing comments, at least to me, stating that he believes Tesla Insurance, over time, could comprise 30 to 40% of the value of their automotive business. And I'm pleased to report, after a few weeks of scratching my head wondering WTF, I believe I finally figured out how Tesla will scale its insurance product to around one-third of its entire automotive business. So strap yourselves in and enjoy the ride. But first, don't forget, if you'd like 3 free stocks, check out the link in the description to Webull, sign up, open a new account, deposit $100, you'll get 3 free stocks, 2 of them valued between $8 and $1,600 each. And if you're in Australia, the UK or New Zealand, you can get a free stock with Stake, also using the link in the description. Let's get back to it. Earlier this year in March, so 8 months ago, I posted a video about Tesla Insurance, which to my surprise actually reached a lot of people, nearly 500,000 in fact. However, I know that the channel has since added around 100,000 new subscribers, and many of you won't have seen that video. So what I'm going to do before we get into the numbers and how Tesla can scale their insurance revenues, I'm actually going to replay the majority of that video and add a few more notes where I think it's relevant. If you don't want to watch this, you want to skip ahead, that's fine. I'll put a timestamp in the corner so you know where to skip to. Let's get into it. Those of you familiar with legendary investor Warren Buffett will know he built his empire on the back of insurance businesses starting more than half a century ago. The automotive insurance market in just the United States is almost $300 billion today, and Tesla is uniquely positioned to take a disproportionately large slice of this relative to its fleet size, as its product offering will be almost impossible to compete with. How insurance works. First, a quick primer on insurance. The most important piece of the insurance puzzle are actuaries. These are well-paid professionals who analyze financial risk using mathematics, statistics, and financial theories. Their job is to determine how much of a premium must be charged to customers to statistically ensure a profitable company. If premiums are too low, insurance payouts will bankrupt the company. If they're too high, no one will buy your insurance. It's a fine line, and the better your data, the more clarity you have around risk and the more accurately you can price your insurance product. The thing is, most actuaries have access to the same data. It's broad and general. Tesla, however, has a ridiculous competitive advantage. The data. A Tesla truly is a smartphone on wheels. The onboard telemetry is out of control. Every time you plug in at home, your Tesla is uploading a mountain of anonymous driving data to help improve Tesla's self-driving AI, among other things. Data is so important in pricing insurance risk that many insurance companies will provide customers a telematics device to install in their vehicles, which measures things like speed, acceleration, and braking to determine how safe you are as a driver, and thus price your insurance accordingly. Well, Tesla has more data than anyone else by a stupid margin. While Tesla Insurance doesn't utilize this data yet, you can bet they will over time, and by doing so, we'll be able to either drop prices, increase margins, or both. I really want to stress how important this is. No other insurance company can know what Tesla can about the driving habits of a Tesla driver. No one can therefore price insurance as accurately and cheaply as Tesla will be able to. It just won't be possible to compete. Tesla knows when you brake, accelerate, how fast you do both, your reaction times, whether you're in ludicrous mode, whether you're launching at every set of lights, whether you're following too close, whether you're staying in your lane, how aggressively you turn your wheel, whether the aircon is on, whether music is playing, whether your hands are on the wheel, and with a suite of cameras and other sensors available, what's going on around the car, and perhaps, if you give them permission, Tesla Insurance may even know if your eyes were on the road. Hey guys, a quick update for you. As we can see here from Green the Only, an alleged hacker who appears to have found some of the source code regarding Tesla's software and driver monitoring systems, which appear to be looking for things like blinking, eyes closed, eyes nominal, head down, looking left, looking right, using a phone, etc. So the driver monitoring, at least the groundwork, the infrastructure to make this happen in the future, does appear to be in place.
I won't be surprised if, in the future, Tesla allows customers to opt into full insurance data, giving Tesla more data in exchange for an even more competitive insurance premium. So, one more time. Other insurers will have literally no hope of competitively offering insurance for Tesla vehicles when Tesla themselves has a gargantuan and exclusive data advantage. There's no getting around this. As Tesla Insurance expands throughout the US, it's hard to imagine more than a marginal number of Tesla owners insuring with another provider. Even with bundled discounts, it will be incredibly hard to price better than Tesla. What other auto insurer can say it only insures a fleet of vehicles that are way safer than anything else on the road and will continue to get safer over time? Answer, none, for now. Autonomy. And that brings us to autonomy, or full self-driving. As we transition to autonomous driving, there will still be accidents. Less than if these vehicles were being human-driven, but stuff happens. Tesla themselves have said that when a fully autonomous Tesla crashes, the software is at fault, as in Tesla is liable, not the owner of the vehicle. Had Tesla not entered the insurance space, this could be a big, big problem. What insurer is going to provide insurance for a self-driving car? How will they price risk? It's so radically different and new that it's hard to imagine how things would play out. My best guess is extraordinarily high premiums until insurers gather enough real-world data to begin pricing better. The timing of Tesla Insurance is impeccable, and I may be hallucinating here, but I get the feeling Tesla are offering insurance now so that when autonomy is solved, they'll already have trekked into the uncharted terrain of insurance around self-driving vehicles and have a competitively priced product that gives owners peace of mind. Whether you believe Tesla solves full self-driving this year or this decade doesn't matter. When they do, and the robotaxi fleet awakens, you can bet Tesla Insurance will be there to give robotaxi owners peace of mind. Pricing pressure. So far, most Californian Tesla Insurance customers are paying premiums around 20% lower than competitors. In some cases, this is as much as 30% lower. This has two effects. The first is that many budget-conscious customers will make the switch to Tesla Insurance to save money. The second is to put pricing pressure on other insurers. It's no secret that today, most companies charge through the nose to insure a Tesla. Why? It's new, and their actuaries don't have enough data to clearly price risk, so they take a conservative approach to pricing. Tesla publishing their quarterly safety data and itself offering competitive insurance premiums will put pricing pressure on other insurers, at least if they want any hope of insuring Tesla vehicles in the future. But remember, no matter how much safety data Tesla does publish, no one will have access to the same depth and breadth of individual driver data than Tesla. No one will be able to compete on price unless they suffer lower margins. Fat float. Back to legendary investor Warren Buffett. I mentioned he built his empire on the back of insurance companies, but how? Let's read about the float. Float, or available reserve, is the amount of money on hand at any given moment that an insurer has collected in insurance premiums but has not paid out in claims. So, what is one to do with all that money? Well, leaving it sitting around is pretty boneheaded when you can put it to work, and that's exactly what he's done. Insurers start investing insurance premiums the moment they're collected, earning interest, dividends, and other income until claims are paid out. In the case of Tesla, this float can be used to accelerate their expansion, drive costs down, grow R&D efforts, improve the self-driving AI, and well, just about anything that doesn't put the capital at enormous risk.
Just to be clear, I don't know the actual specifics of what Tesla can and can't use their float for, but I just want to illustrate a point.
And over time, as safety features improve, less payouts will occur, meaning more of that float becomes pure profit for Tesla. If we use a $2,000 annual insurance premium as our starting point, we can do some very quick back-of-the-napkin calculations. 10,000 insurance customers equals $20 million of float every year. 100,000 customers equals $200 million every year. 1 million customers equals $2 billion, enough to build a gigafactory every year. Keep in mind, today, Tesla's entire fleet is around 1 million vehicles, with more than 500,000 additional deliveries expected this year alone. By the middle of this decade, Tesla's fleet will be many millions strong. The potential here is enormous. Overheads, margins, and vertical integration. Tesla is a ruthlessly lean and efficient optimization machine. Adding on an automotive insurance product to its existing automotive business is a perfect synergy, creating cost advantages that standalone insurers do not have. It's just the way of vertical integration. One example of this is advertising. Tesla's vehicles are so good they sell themselves. To date, Tesla has never paid for an advertisement or endorsement. They don't have to. Picture this future. You buy a Tesla, and at the time of purchase, Tesla offers to bundle insurance with your car. Many will sign up for the convenience alone. Others will shop around only to discover Tesla insurance is the cheapest available anyway. How, as a competitor, will you have any hope in reaching, let alone winning the business of, a Tesla owner? How much will you have to spend on advertising? How low will your margins need to be to compete? Good luck. The future I envision is one in which almost every Tesla owner has Tesla insurance, effectively meaning Tesla has self-insured its entire fleet. The take rate is sure to be incredibly high because Tesla will have the best data and therefore the best pricing. Incremental improvements in active safety and autopilot will compound across the entire Tesla fleet, saving mountains, I mean mountains of cash that was once reserved for insurance payouts and will no longer be needed. So too will the exponentially increasing swaths of driver data. Tesla will continue to get better at pricing risk by using real-world driver-specific data, leading to bigger margins and or lower premiums. Everyone wins. Expansion into other insurance. Alright, hear me out. I suspect long-term, Tesla will enter into home insurance and that their foray into automotive insurance is just the first step. The ideal Tesla customer has a Tesla or two parked in their garage, charging from a Tesla power wall which was fed by photons collected by solar panels or the solar glass roof. Easily six figures worth of Tesla products in one place. These are all big ticket items and it makes sense that if Tesla already has insurance infrastructure, offering home insurance is a logical next step. Bundled insurance premiums can be super competitive. Compounded with the innate data advantages Tesla has for automotive insurance, and it's not beyond the realms of possibility that Tesla will be able to compete with the biggest in the business by not just offering automotive insurance, but home insurance too. And this is a subject for another more speculative video, but I won't be surprised if Tesla gets fully into the smart home business, including climate control systems. This would incentivize Tesla even more into offering home insurance, but more on that in a future video. To sum it up, Tesla Insurance is a real sleeper product. As it's only available in California right now, few owners know of it, few investors think of it, and few analysts recognize its potential. The insurance industry literally revolves around pricing risk. Whoever can price risk best usually wins. And how do you price risk? With data. The best data means the best value premium. If your data sucks, you have more uncertainty and need to be more conservative, thus forcing your premiums higher to cover the what-ifs. But Tesla will have far fewer what-ifs. They'll know more about their vehicles in general terms, and they'll know more about their drivers than anyone else, and their vehicles get safer over time. You can't compete with that. Tesla Insurance will dominate and transform the industry. I can't imagine a future in which most Tesla owners are not also Tesla Insurance customers. And as this happens, the automotive insurance industry is set for major disruption. Picture this. In a world of electric autonomous vehicles, each gathering gargantuan amounts of useful driver behavior and safety data, traditional automotive insurance models are worthless. Statistical tables are general and useful, but hyper-specific driver-centric data is on a whole other level and infinitely more valuable. Once again, Tesla is leading the way and everyone else will soon be trying to catch up. The way I see this playing out is that automakers of the future, much like Tesla today, will look to partner exclusively with an insurance company or start their own, which gains opt-in telemetry access to its fleet, enabling more competitive pricing on insurance by using driver-specific data over generic actuarial data. At present, no other automaker or insurer can even collect this data, so for now, Tesla Insurance has no competition, which means lower premiums for customers and higher margins for Tesla. And it only gets better from here. Remember, the safer Tesla's autopilot software becomes, the less accidents will occur and the more float can be used to accelerate Tesla's mission. This matters.
So now let's do the numbers and work out how on earth Tesla Insurance could possibly make up a third of their future automotive business. There's two key components to how Tesla Insurance can scale to be around a third of the auto business. The first is robo-taxis and the higher utilization rates. The second is the fact that Tesla has developed a million mile battery. Now, maybe they didn't advertise that directly at Battery Investor Day, but it was there. It was the iron phosphate battery chemistry. Mark my words. So, let's look at the implications of these two factors. And before we get into the numbers, I just want to quickly explain these are very rough and approximate. Once again, don't get your panties in a twist. Use your own numbers. I'm just trying to illustrate a point and make an example, not to make a prediction about the future. So please don't get bogged down. I literally said this yesterday in a video, don't get your panties in a twist. And about a dozen of you did get your panties in a twist. Please don't be that guy. I won't be as gentle next time. So the first component is robo-taxis and their high utilization rate. Let's pull a number out of my ass. Let's say $1,000 is the typical insurance premium for somebody who's just driving the vehicle for their own purposes, much lower utilization. So $1,000 per customer who's not part of the robo-taxi fleet. What if you are part of the robo-taxi fleet? You're probably going to be utilizing this vehicle far more often. All things being equal, that would imply a larger insurance premium, right? It's more likely to be per mile, right? If this vehicle is being used 5 or 10 times as much as one that's for personal use, it's likely to get in 5 to 10 times as many accidents, all other things being equal, so likely your premium will be higher too. Let's just assume that the average robo-taxi insurance premium is only 5 times as much, despite the fact that the utilization rate is going to be much higher. So let's call it a $5,000 insurance premium per Tesla on the robo-taxi network per year. Let's just imagine in the future there is 1 million Teslas as part of the robo-taxi fleet, all paying a $5,000 per year insurance premium. We have $5 billion of revenue in a single year from 1 million insurance premiums as part of the Robotaxi network. If we fast forward a few years to Tesla's release of the $25,000 Robotaxi vehicle, we can understand already that in a single year, an insurance premium of $5,000 would bring in about 20% of the purchase price of that vehicle. What about next year? Another $5,000 and we're at 40%. What about next year? Another $5,000 and we're at 60%. Two more years, and the insurance premiums have now been $25,000, equivalent to the entire purchase price of the vehicle. Now we can start to see how insurance premiums can be a higher proportion of Tesla's overall automotive business. And now we talk about the implications of the million-mile battery and powertrain. Teslas are going to last a lot longer than other vehicles. So let's look at some numbers. So here we are looking at my Tesla production estimates running all the way through 2030. Again, use your own numbers, these are mine. We have a total of Tesla producing around 100 million vehicles between now and 2030. Again, use your own numbers. Just for the record, the entire global automotive fleet is around 1 billion vehicles. So this scenario would see Tesla displacing just 10% of the entire global automotive fleet by 2030. Not as crazy as it sounds. If Tesla sells 20 million or so vehicles in 2030, but it has an existing fleet of around 100 million vehicles and each customer is paying an insurance premium, let's see what the numbers turn out like. I'm going to keep things super simple rather than separating out robo-taxis from regular personal use vehicles. I'm just going to assume that the average insurance premium for a vehicle in Tesla's active fleet of vehicles on roads in 2030 of around 100 million vehicles is $2,500 per year. Let's multiply that out by the network and brace for impact, guys. This is a ridiculous number. $250 billion of insurance revenue in 2030. Bruh, $250 billion in insurance premiums, are you high? Why, yes I am, but my point still stands. So per my model, I've got Tesla selling around 20 million vehicles in 2030. Of course, use your own numbers, I won't judge you. These are what I'm working with. If the average selling price of a Tesla around that time is $35,000, now just keep in mind, Tesla has already announced they'll have a $25,000 vehicle in 2022-23. That price is going to continue to come down over time. 7 years later, that's probably going to be an $18,000 to $20,000 vehicle, not including full self-driving, etc. So let's use a $35,000 base price per vehicle sold in 2030. Multiplying that out by the fleet, we have $700 billion in automotive revenue. Wait a minute. These numbers are looking rather interesting now, aren't they? That insurance premium total that we had for the same year of sales on Tesla vehicles came in at $250 billion. We throw that over $700 billion. Would you look at that? 35-36% of the automotive business from insurance premiums. Thank you. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how Tesla gets to insurance making up around one-third or more of its automotive business over time. And if anyone's wondering, the world's largest company by revenue today, Walmart, does around $500 billion per year in revenue. Based on my models and my numbers, which again came out of my rectum, so use your own, but based on my numbers, in 10 years' time, Tesla could be doing about half of the revenue of the world's largest company today just from a tiny sliver of its business, insuring its automotive products. This matters. I'm Stephen Mark Ryan. This is Solving the Money Problem, and I love you all. Don't forget, if you'd like 3 free stocks, check out the link in the description to Webull. Sign up, open a new account, deposit $100, you'll get 3 free stocks, 2 of them valued between $8 and $1,600 each. And if you're in Australia, the UK or New Zealand, you can get a free stock with Stake, also using the link in the description.
Thanks so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And of course, if you have any ideas for future videos, let me know. I read all your comments. P.S. If you're still watching, you're awesome. If you'd like early access, exclusive videos, regular Q&As, our private Discord server and more, consider supporting the channel at patreon.com/solvingthemoneyproblem so I can keep creating content for you guys. There's a link in the description. You can now also become a member of the channel for some exclusive perks. To learn more, click the join button next to subscribe. And don't forget to check out our merch store. Either way, the best form of support is you being here and watching, so thanks again.